Welcome back to Life and Style. This is Artistic Tuesday, and I hope you're having an amazing time as I am. Remember to keep talking to us, keep suggesting. If you want to come on the show, the platform to use is our social media pages. That's the KTN Life and Style on Facebook, KTN Life underscore Style on Twitter and Instagram. You can send us an email on lifeandstyle@standardmedia.co.ke. We are on visual arts and on photography in particular. And I've got Alex Gabriel in studio. Thank you for coming.
Thank you.
You look amazing.
Thank you
and
so much.
And very excited about the show today.
Well, I am.
Yeah, so let's talk. You know what you did? We were setting up and then you just moved that from here.
Yeah.
I don't want to imagine how much money it costs. And you told me this is okay. I can handle this one.
Tell you what, I cannot do without both.
Oh, you can. You know? Okay, fine. I'll take care of that.
Yeah.
So maybe a bit of background, Alex, about yourself and photography.
Well, tell you what, interesting. I'm a photographer currently, but this is not what I've been for the last 3 years.
Whoa.
Previously, I was in the corporate field and more specifically in the financial sector.
Are you serious?
Yeah, worked in the banking industry. Having had a background in computer science and statistics. But, my passion had always been in photography. And probably just had to do what I needed to do for the sake of my folks,
okay.
You know. But for the last 3 years now, I've been doing photography.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Professionally?
Professionally, yeah.
Self-taught, or did you have to go to school now?
Well, tell you what, I've fortunately or unfortunately not been, you know, been in a class per se, but thank God for the technology that there is today. So I'm a YouTube student.
I swear, there's so many Yegos set the pace.
Oh, yeah. I'm another Yego, but now in this particular case, I'm a photographer.
Yego going on over
there. Yeah. So I'm a YouTube student, and it's amazing the amount of content that there is on YouTube.
And knowledge as well.
And knowledge as well,
okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So you've been going on for 3 years.
Yeah.
How has it been? How is the industry? And what does Alex Gabriel Photography do in particular? Is it specified for a particular field or not?
Tell you what, so the journey has been interesting. I mean, coming from a different industry altogether and joining a new line, having to make new friends, new contacts, new networks. But God has been gracious. I always give credit back to God and my family. I'm a married man with a beautiful daughter and a beautiful wife, unless I'm killed.
Yes, I was waiting for that.
You know, they've been pretty supportive in the moments when the business has been taking a little bit longer to pick up, and the network such as PAK, which is Photographers Association of Kenya, a whole bunch of photographers who come together and just really, you know, support one another in the field of photography. My general photography, and good question that you've asked, I do baby photography.
Whoa.
And more specifically, I'm looking at toddlers. You know, we're looking from 1 month to 2 months to 3 months, and coupled with family photography. So it's unlikely that you're going to find me doing a lot of other kind of photography, but then I do have an opportunity once in a while to do such like weddings and a little bit of corporate work. But my passion and area of interest is with babies.
Why them?
Tell you what, I think while growing up, and I would bet maybe with you, I'll make an assumption on this case, we didn't get an opportunity to have some documentation of our growth pattern.
Okay, yes.
All right? True. And we look back and try to figure out from the stories that sometimes you're told by our parents, you know, you are this, you are that. There's a joke in my family that goes that I was one time big. You know? you know.
But do they have evidence?
They don't have the evidence, all right? And as we grow up, I think there is also a need to appreciate where we are coming from, right? By looking at when I was a toddler to the point when I started walking, to the time when I started winning, to the time when I went to school. I think there's a beautiful story that can be told through photography all the way from baby age and more specifically from the toddler. And I don't mind being around kids. I think I'm a big baby, but, you know, at heart.
At heart. That's very, very unique. And that means, I don't think many people are specializing in that. So that means the market is huge.
Well, the market
and
is
now,
huge.
Even with the trends and people have changed, they now document the first step, the first word they say.
Exactly.
It's like they're always there waiting.
Yeah.
So it's a really, really good field. Never thought about it.
It is a very interesting field. And like you said, we got a lot of babies coming by and even families. I mean, if I could talk a little bit about families, I think the moments I would sit back behind my camera and really have an opportunity to capture a family where daddy and mommy and their kids have come by the studio or probably have gone to location, because I do go to location sometimes. Mm-hmm. I think the best moment I deduce from that is when I get to see the smile on mommy and daddy, and sometimes daddy holding mommy, and sometimes mommy, you know, will be always like, I've not felt this hug from my husband in a while, you know?
Yeah.
And so photography brings that togetherness in the family when the son can actually sit on the daddy's lap and the daughter sitting on the mommy's lap, and just bringing that family feel together. But more importantly, when you get to capture that photo and then they're able to place it on a wall, it means like a constant reminder to them of what they're supposed to be as a family. I am a believer of family.
That's really good. And yeah. It's really intense.
Yeah.
That it's not just photography.
Yeah.
It's bigger and broader and more deep than just capturing a moment.
Sure.
Because now you're looking at a family that will look at this picture and it will remind them what they're always supposed to be.
That
because there's
true.
No one will come to be taking a photo and they're grumpy.
No.
Until they're like this.
You got to smile when you come to my studio.
Absolutely.
You got to smile. I'll be the first one to smile at you and you'll definitely have to give it back to me.
Okay.
Yeah.
You know, Todd, weddings, why don't you like weddings or these other corporate events?
I know that I hate or dislike. Mm-hmm. My heart is more with babies.
That's it.
That's it. Give me 2 hours, 3 hours with the babies.
And you're okay.
You know, I'll tell you what, folks come by with this, by my studio with their toddlers, and we have like 2 or 3 hours, and the baby sometimes is becoming fussy. And I have a microwave in the studio. I have a cot for the baby where they can sleep. I have a couch for the mom and dad where they can sit back. And I'll never do 2 shoots in a given day when I have babies coming by, because I really want to give them the time, right? And babies are like you and I, who we can pose. We need them in their perfect, their real self. Their real self. And so it calls for a lot of patience. You know, very interesting. I don't have a lot of patience. And
you must be amazing. Because I was going to ask, because when you get a baby in the studio and they probably, you know, fussy, they want to sleep, they don't want to, they want to eat, they want to play.
Yeah.
Capturing those moments, you need a lot of patience.
You definitely do. You definitely do. But you also have to be, to have the love for.
Okay.
As besides, you know, the patience, you have got to have the love for the kids. And just understanding that, you know, well, one time I was a baby myself and somebody had the patience for me, you know, and the love to try and be around me. And I'm told I was a piece of work anyway.
Yeah.
So it's my time to give back.
Okay.
Yeah.
Very, very interesting. So where are you located? Are you on social media?
Yes, I am on social media. Mm-hmm. But yeah, I'm located in Parklands, mm-hmm. Maharaja Building.
Okay.
Right opposite Mpisha, just look at that.
Ah.
So when the babies are coming from the hospital, when mamas give birth
strategy.
And deliver, you know, when the mothers deliver or when they're coming for their, you know,
clinics.
For their clinics,
yeah.
They got their stop, which is at my studio. And it really works magic for them. As a matter of fact, I'll tell you what, the feedback I get from them is we're able to kill 2 birds with 1 stone.
Yeah.
Come by the studio, come and go to the clinic, and eventually when the baby is delivered, I can even go to the hospital and get a couple of moments of when the baby has just been born. It's usually glorious and heavenly.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay, Maharaj Building on social media.
Alex Gabriel Photography, that is on Facebook and Instagram, and AG Photography on Twitter.
On Twitter.
Yeah.
Okay. Imagine time is gone. It's done. Just like that. Just like
good.
That.
Right.
But I hope you had fun.
I had fun. That was good.
Okay.
I got my life back.
This has been Photography. Let's move over to Creative of the Week.
Cecilia Customs. Okay, that's my job name, but my actual name is Asila Joseph. I'm a matatu designer / graffiti. Graffiti is the art of using paint in different forms. Yeah? It depends on the artist, how he puts it down. By you can use it on drawing, or you can do it by different forms, like there's paper art. No, it comes in various forms depending on the artist. I started doing art when I was still in primary school, before art was removed from the syllabus which we used to do. So I found myself actually interested in drawing cartoons, matatus which were there at that time. and various things. Many, I used to love art. So as I went on, I found graffiti being so interesting. My brother used to go with various matatus which were decorated, and I found interest in them. So after which I came up and decided to do matatu art after I finished my high school, before I went to the college. Okay, I remember my first matatu art. It was back in 2007. It wasn't appealing that much, but you know, you have to start from somewhere. Yeah, so after that, I went on doing another one and another one and another one until I perfected my skill, until now where I am. I've painted a lot of matatus, various routes, about all major routes in Nairobi. The ones which I have not painted, just a very few routes. So first of all, you have to show your interest in matatu. Then what you do next, you start doing with those who are in the industry. Yeah, you just can't come and start doing matatu and you get a matatu. You have to get known by the investors. They see you with your teacher, the person who is there, you see? The person who was there before you, at least he is known. After that, you know, some investors usually fear doing work with the mostly known matatu designers because of their price, whatever. So they prefer looking for the cheaper price. And the only way you can find the cheaper price is by going to the people who are an upcoming. You know, upcomings are always cheaper than the people who are there. Yeah? So when you're given that chance, it's where you have to use your chance well, so that people can know there's someone like you who exists there. Before I started doing graffiti art, I used to do house art, where we used to go and paint, like, let's say a child's bedroom. You decorate it with cartoon images. Main bedrooms, you decorate it with flowers, depending on the customer's choice. Yes, you can practice the art on a board, paper, depending on how you want it. There's a lot of place you can practice on. My favorite art is matatu, of course, because I earn a living from there. So, but before I used to do even the canvas art, but right now I can say matatu art is my favorite. The service depends on how the customer wants it to be. You know, there is no tag price of doing art. It only depends on how the customer wants it to be. You can want it to be an extreme matatu manyanga, you know what I mean. There it has its own price. Let's say, for example, the City offers the metro tours, yeah? That one, you'll charge him a low cost, because if you look at it, there's no graffiti. Then it comes to the second stage where you have a matatu which has the circle color, but is decorated at least with some few things. You can have one portrait there and a name. Yeah? Then it comes to the extreme. The extreme is the one which you can find like five portraits, a name, different graffiti. It has several colors. It's not a must, it has a lot of colors, but it only depends with the design. I basically use a compressor machine and paints. Pia design inaweza kufanya utumie vitu zingine tofauti, like you can use a broom depending on your design. You can use grease. You can inaweza hata tukitumia hiki kiti tunaweza tumia na tutoe design nayo. Unaona venye iko na pattern. So it only depends with the art you are doing. Art ya Montatu ni kama tu job. Eh? It's like a musician, sio kila mtu anaweza imba, umeona? Ndio unaweza pea mtu job afanye, but it won't make everybody happy. Ama ndio huwezi furahisha kila mtu, lakini nakwambia, you know art, lazima watu wa appreciate. Mtu akiona, he says the design is good. Eh? So, mimi ka artist naweza sema, I don't think everybody can do art. Yes, it's just like any other job. My skills, you know, every time you do a new job, you perfect your skills. The more you are doing it, every time you are doing it, you perfect your skill. Like me, I've done it from 2007 till now. You can see that's almost 10 years. Yes, so the more you do it, it's like a child when he starts walking. The more he does it, the more he becomes confident in walking. You see, yes, that's how I perfect my skill. The Matatu art has had some many challenges. Like, for example, the first challenge was when the police used to disarm the Matatus because of graffiti, until the president came out and said, we do the art. The other challenge is, I can say, is the how the art cost. Like, for example, many customers, when they are told the price, wanashtukanga, unajua. So wanaogopa. Unakuta customer ulimwambia, anakupigia simu, just a random customer. Anaweza kuwa amechukua namba kwa gari fulani tu, umeweka nini yako, akupigia simu. Then he or she asks you, utanifanyia gari yangu na pesa ngapi? Then you tell him the price. Anashtuka, unajua, jua, watu waamini kama art inaweza fika hiyo pesa, umeona. But what people don't know, ile art tukifanya kwa hiyo Matatu, itaende kulete pesa wewe. Hawezi kumpea gari kuna art na hii gari yenye ina, umeona. Na ile gari venye itatoka pale, hakuna siku utaenda uambie customer, leo nimelala kwangu nja, nitumie ka kitu juu nilikuchorea gari yako, umeona. So lazima pia sisi tujijenge kama artist, umeona. Hapo kwa cost pia ndio shida. Alafu pia shida ingine inakuja, the new upcoming artist, eh? Wanaharibu bei. Umeona, unaweza pata umelipisha 100,000, then another artist, because he hajazoea pesa, ataambiwa 30,000. Aone ni pesa mingi sana, umeona, juu yeye hajazoea kushika hiyo pesa. So the customer will prefer him over you, you see. So that's another challenge. Yeah? The other challenge is the price tag on the materials we use is usually high. Since those people, they always think like the way other people think. I wanna jua, watu wanalipishanga gari 100,000. Eh? Kumaanisha, hii gari iko na pesa sana, umeona? So they keep the price high. for the things we use. So that's another big challenge. Those people who do walls graffiti, like in the CBD, you can see some. They are members of our community, of course, but they are doing it the different way. Au pia ni ma artist. Ni kama tu venye tumesema, kuna mtu wa kujenga nyungu, kuna mtu wa kujenga kiti, hu ni artist pia yeye. Ni msanii, but in a different way. You see, if you went to an art class, you remember there are different parts of art. There were culinary art, there was performing art, and there was this we are doing, the art we are doing, which is the art, the paintings, poultry, hizo zote. So hao watu pia ni kama sisi, but hao wanaifanya vingine, na mtu anafanyanga hiyo kitu na purpose. This has been the source of living since 2007. Hata ile time kulikuwa na noma, tulikuwa tu tunang'ang'ana nayo hivyo venye iko. Yes, mi sina job ingine, na hiyo ndio imenifikisha mahali niko 10 years now. The importance of the skill is that kama singekuwa na hii skill right now, I could be somewhere else. Maybe I could be a thief. Maybe I could be someone useless in the society. So this skill has really helped me. That's why I see it important to me.
What we do here is go back.
When you want to create a piece of artwork, first of all, you have to have the idea of what you want to do, of what your client wants, and of what you feel will be good to your client. Unajua, sometimes client anaweza kuja kwambie, like most of the clients wanakuja na kwambia, mimi nataka gari yangu chore Yesu, you know. But to my thinking, I know there's no one who has ever seen Jesus. Yeah. The person we draw is some actor. So, unaweza mu-advise badala ya kuchora Yesu. So, like, if you walk around Nairobi, the most used theme is gospel theme. Mtu anaamini gospel. So, unaweza mu-advise, sio lazima tuchore gospel. Umeona? Haya. Sasa, kitu mtu anafanya, lazima uko na idea. Ukishakuwa na idea, kuna mashine inajiita plotter. Kazi yake huko ya kuenlarge. Umeona? Ukisha come up na image, tuseme una come up na image, tuseme kama ya hii ring. Ukisha come up nayo, una sketch ka kitu kadogo, unaipeleka kwa image, kwa plotter. Then the plotter does the enlargement depending on your size. Okay? Let's say you are doing a 1 meter wall. Utaenda kwa plotter uweke hiyo size ya hiyo 1 meter. Tayari uko na kale ka image kako, ume scan, iko kwa computer, then you enlarge it. Ukisha enlarge it, itaitoa kwa tracing paper ya brown. Kama ni portrait, like portrait na nini ziko na tofauti, ziko na different stages. Like portrait, ukisha enlarge kwa plotter, ukamu trace kwa body. Eh? Kwa body you use a carbon paper, then you trace it, itatokea kwa body. Ikisha tokea, you take something called an airbrush. Eh? You use it to spray it depending on your image. How many, tuseme, for example, you are doing a name, you have to create the stencil. You stencil, you take a layer masking tape, you use the carbon paper, you trace, mixture trace, you use the cutting knife, real paper knife. You cut it on how the name is eco. After that, you weed the unwanted part. So, unakuja na rangi, una spray, ile place umetoa, unajua. Sasa juu rangi itashika masking tape, huku mali ulikuwa umetoa, itashika rangi. Umeelewa? Ikishashika, unaipea some few minutes, depending on paint unatumia. Kazi nye natumia nza kukauka instant. Ukimaliza, unatoa tape, hiyo jina itakuwa hapo.
Wahuni walikuwa shatoweka nikawa walikuwa na master key. Kisha kuambiwa ati dead they must be. Ni kweli unachopanda lazima utashuka. Akili ni nywele ndio zangu nimezishuka.
And if your enemy is your fear, let your faith be the spear. And if your mind is the battlefield, let his wisdom be the shield. So the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want.
Schism D, spoken word for life. Jokomanata Kinkora, Meja na Madrax. Ati wakikamu wakitaka kulabo, bado nitawa cancel.
That was really genius.